Alright, so here goes. Enough of the ridiculous vandal talk. But I'm gonna discuss the cancer of our civilization. Okay. When you look at yourself, you know, you're a decidant. Are you a helper cell? Or are you an antagonizer? Look at yourself as a cell, as is same as within the human body, as the same as is in within the galaxies, and just as there are hard planets that are essentially evil, that bash into others and kill them outright. And then you have the helper planets that have that good atmosphere, that have that good rotational hold, where there's security. Your planet nearby, and there's no pandemonium. Okay, so there's a safety there with those planets. So those are helper planets. So you look at the big body. The big body that we're talking about. Out there, you can look at the big body. You can look at the medium bodies of ourselves. You know, each one helper cell, or antagonizer cell. And then you can look even smaller. You can get into that microscope, you know, look at the blood. Of course, you can always do that. But it is funner always to look at us as being those cells, and then go out and look higher, look out into the galaxy itself. So. We'll bring it back to us, okay? Bring it back to human. Oh my gosh, it's so frictious, isn't it? Human, ugh. Okay, so we have the human helper cell. Now, okay, so here you've got the helper that says, yes, I want continuance. Yes, I want this planet species group. Not the planet species group, but the planet bio-organism to continue. I want the plants, animal species, blah, blah, blah. To continue, not a suicidal state, la la la. We want all of that good, you know, not a destructive that kills off a species by species by species. You know, one type that kills off all the others. You know, we don't want that imbalance. So that's a helper. So we have this helper cell, the helper person. So then I'm like, well. And then we have go back to that antagonizer again. So you have the antagonizer. And then we have the ones who are the helper. They thought they were helper cells, or they try to pretend to be helper cells. But in reality, they've been tainted. They've been tainted by the antagonizer cell. The antagonizer cell being the one who is up for destruction, the one who is up for non-continuance, and doesn't really see a future, that is an existent future for them. It's not one who has insight towards any future endeavors, aside from very short-term lifetime, okay? Not one who sees 100 years from now, or 200, or 5,000, or 8,000 years, just one that only can see this minutia moment as theirs. Okay, so that's the antagonizer. It's because they're short-sighted. Namely, that's a big way they control their antagonism, is they live in that ball of short-sightedness. So you could say that's ignorance. You could say, well, they haven't been taught. It's very possible it's all of those things. But they don't want to listen. A lot of them don't want to listen. Okay. So we're really talking about... I'm tired. We're talking about, the taint... Let's almost look at, in this situation, let's look at, we have the antagonizer. I was going back to my little drawing of the X being evil, the zero being the helper cell, and then the zero helper cell that is filled with the symbols of the X within. So that is the helper thought they were a helper cell, but in reality they are an antagonizer. So they're a clone to the antagonist cells. So we look at them that way as a cancer. We look at them as they have become tainted. Okay, I know I'm repeating myself, but somehow there was a belief mechanism that skewed literally, like you see the cells that get skewed, it skewed their thinking from continuance. They're just all about the me self in their lifetime. So they also are short-termed in their thinking, short-termed in who they are. Okay. So we're talking about, my gosh, yeah, look at yourself as a planet. You're going to be a short-term planet? Because really, it is that, isn't it? If you are an antagonist, you're not going to live very long. Mainly because that is a no purpose reason. That is one that has no planning. I hate to say it. I don't like to plan a lot, but yeah, no big planning. Is one that is erratic, and when I say erratic, I mean you take that planet out there and just, I don't care about tomorrow. You take that planet that's out there like that. That's really what's going on with the antagonizer cell. I don't care about tomorrow. That's what it is saying. So the antagonizer planet is the same way antagonizer asteroids and meteorites, or a planet that's filled with a lot of those types of asteroids and meteorites that have landed there. That it has a disrupted, when it has a disrupted orbit. That type of planet, or a galaxy of those types of planets. So an unstable. So now we're looking back at antagonizer being in its short-sightedness as unstable. An unstable cell, unstable cell group. And for some reason, the centrist ones, the ones that wanted to be helpers, also are attracted to the instability and the non-continuance of the antagonizer group. For some reason, they're attracted. So that is, when we're getting into cancer, they're attracted to what do you call that? I mean, you can almost see it now. You can almost see it out in space. You can see, you can see it in human beings and go, oh, it gets complicated in human beings, doesn't it? It's almost easier in space. I know I try to look at the humans, but they can be complicated. If you look at space, you look at a planet, you look at moons, you look at things that orbit, things that don't orbit, you can almost right away be like, oh my gosh, yeah, absolutely, we're talking instability versus stability out there, again and again and again. And stability is the helper, and instability is the non-helper. So yeah, so when you have the non-helper, let's say you have a beautiful galaxy, everything is just swell, absolutely wow, you know, beautiful colors and bright rings around their planets and just gorgeous, just a gorgeous place. And then all of a sudden careening in, you know, a big antagonizer. It could be a meteor shower interrupter, antagonizer careening in. You can see that instability, that unstable element, set of elements, trying to interrupt and trying to hurt that beautiful galaxy. Trying to bring in non-continuance of their perfect. You know, really, they were getting it perfect. And then you have bam, you know, or boom, or whatever, you know, going in there and causing destruction. You know, so the poor little planets and galaxies that were there are just what happened. Because really, they were wooed into their life as being helper planets, helper cells, helper moons to each other. Helper sun shines. So now, they've had this erratic interruption. So with this erratic interruption, whether it's asteroids, whether it's meteors, whether it's really, it could be a careening planet out of orbit, one that just decided to, that's it, it's flipping turkeys somewhere else, and it ends up in this beautiful space. You know, so when you have that interrupter, you can really almost see, oh my gosh, those helper planets are now, I think it's on me. I think I actually have a bit that has tried to join with my planet. I now have rocks from there. You know, I have rocks, I have meteors that have interrupted the beautiful galaxy that was all helper. And for some reason, those planets are stuck wearing it. Do you understand? They're stuck wearing. They can't really shake off. They can't shake it off. They're stuck wearing those antagonizers. Those antagonizers can be so jolting that they can take moons that they had and move the moons away and cause them to actually move out of their orbits. It can be that disruptive. Anyway, I gotta go. But yeah, we really are trying to talk about the antagonizers and helpers. I'll try to get back to you another time.
Teresa.